Good morning. Welcome everyone to today's webinar. My name is Robert Litera, and in Bacotech Distribution, as a business development manager, I am responsible for sales and sales development of the vendor Datto. Today we are going to talk about how to protect yourself from a costly mistake and basically what solutions from Datto will help you protect yourself from a costly mistake. In the first part, we will discuss about Datto business continuity, a set of tools for data backup, then backup automation for Office 365 and Google Workspace. Later, we will talk about protection, physical, virtual, or cloud infrastructure. And finally, our engineer Błażej Długopolski will present Cyrus console demonstration. To begin with, a few words about the Datto vendor. The company was founded in 2007, currently 23 offices around the world, over 1,800 employees, cooperation only in the partner channel, and 70,000 partners at the moment. The solution on offer are divided into two groups, business management and unified continuity. In the business management category, we have two solutions, Autotask, an ERP system that improves your business process, and Datto RMM, a remote monitoring and management of your IT or customer environment. Today, we are going to focus on the unified continuity category, and here we have two solutions available, Cyrus, which is a hybrid backup to the device replicated to the cloud, and Datto SaaS protection and backup of user data for Office 365 service and Google G Suite, but actually Google Workspace. Let's start by discussing Datto SaaS protection. And the Datto SaaS protection is the most automated, secure, and scalable set and forget backup product for MSPs protection, protecting more than 3.5 million end users from data lost to date. The solution provides fast recovery from data loss in Office 365 or Google Workspace. Thanks to these solutions, we can set automatic backup three times a day for Office 365 emails, contacts, calendars, OneDrive, SharePoint, and Microsoft Teams. And for Google Workspace, Gmail, contacts, calendar, and Team Drives. What you can achieve with Datto SaaS protection? Basically, unlimited data, store as much data you want for as long as you want, no extra charge, point-in-time snapshots allowing you to restore your entire account to a previous state, and security controls with 256-bit encryption. The most important functionalities of the system include a management portal, easily determine the number of licenses in use and view customer backup status from a single dashboard, restore and export, quickly restore or export data from a specific point in time before a data loss event occurs, restore process, quickly identify and recover individual objects on your entire account with associated records and folder structure intact. Restore between users, you can restore data from one Microsoft 365 or Google Workspace user account to another. Preserve user data, keep your Google Workspace user data inactive with SaaS protection for as long as you need it. Easy exports, so you can export entire accounts or specific items in standard file formats. A daily backup report, detailed reporting allows you to confirm the health and status of backup snapshots per client and application and quickly correct actions as needed. One in three companies reporting losing data stored in cloud-based applications. The most common causes of data loss is user mistakes, malware attacks such as ransomware, malicious user actions, and accidental overwriting of data. So let's see advantages of Datto SaaS protection for Office 365 and Google Workspace. Automated backups, simple integration, flexible backup retention, MSP-friendly management portal, restore and export data in real time, granular restore process, restore data from different users, user data preservation, protection against ransomware, backup monitoring, daily backup success report, transparent and simple licensing, and flexible deployment options. Data to SaaS protection, deployment options and licensing. Minimum purchase, one license, minimum length of service, 1 month, implementation, cloud environment hosted by the vendor. And finally, two options to deploy, time-based retention, snapshots of backup are stored for up to 1 year in DataCloud, and infinite cloud retention, backup snapshots are stored in the DataCloud infinitely. The second solutions for the data protection and business continuity is Datto-Cyrus. Cyrus is a full-featured comprehensive data protection platform delivered in one integrated package. User can easily protect physical, virtual, or cloud infrastructures based on Windows, Mac, or Linux operating system. Series 4 and 4X appliances guarantee immediate restore option of the environment at the optimum time for the user. Cyrus can be deployed as a physical device, a virtual device, or just as software. Cyrus 4 and 4X are equipped with latest generation Intel Xeon and Skylark processors to seamlessly support complex virtualized environments. Intel obtain SSDs, error correction RAM to ensure no data corruption. Cyrus Virtual Appliance provides the full feature set of the Cyrus platform for companies that prefer to deploy a virtual service. The solutions work with VMware vSphere and Microsoft Hyper-V and is available in a wide range of local storage options from 1 terabyte to 60 terabytes. And finally, Cyrus Image is a device accessible using the USB imaging tool. The solution transforms a wide range of backup and disaster recovery devices and other user-supplied hardware into a full Datto-Cyrus appliance. Simply insert the USB key to available hardware and Cyrus Image installed the entire Cyrus platform. Datto-Cyrus BCDR key functionalities. Restore option for each type. Datto Restore toolkit can take any task with option ranging for granular restore that can target specific files. Instant virtualizations, if a service goes down in the company, the protected system can be immediately virtualized on a Datto appliance in the secure Datto cloud. Restore or virtualize snapshots. Datto stores backup, so if it can be virtualized directly. Datto provides private clouds. Datto centers are localized all over the world, and customers can easily choose where to store their data. Protect all your infrastructure, protect any physical, virtual, and cloud infrastructure running on Windows, Mac, or Linux that you deploy as an appliance image or virtual system. Advanced backup verification, Datto gives you 100% confidence that your backup will run with your data intact and without a ransomware. And detection and recover of ransomware, the backups are stored in a secure location and scanned to ensure they don't contain ransomware. If you become a victim of ransomware, you can simply rewind time to a snapshot from before the attack. And finally, time unlimited retention in the cloud storage. Your data in Datto cloud for unlimited period in time. Infinite cloud retention is perfect for long-term archiving and organizations subject to regulatory requirements. So, and Datto Cyrus implementation and licensing options, minimum purchase one device, minimum duration of service 1 year, implementation device installed in customer infrastructures, and two deployment options, time burst retention, snapshots of backup are stored for up to 1 year in the Datto cloud, and infinite cloud retention, snapshots of backups are stored in the Datto cloud infinitely. Thank you for this part. That's all from my side. And now I invite you to a demo show of the Datto-Cyrus console, which will be present by Błażej Długopolski.
Thank you very much, Robert. My name is Wojciech Dugopolski. I'm Process Engineer in the Data Company. In the Bakotech Company from the Data Solutions. Today, I will show you the console of the Cyrus solution that is used to be for the local and cloud backup. I will show you my screen in a moment so you can see my web console that I have access to it. You should see my screen right now. Okay, everything is fine. This is the normal dashboard of our appliance that is in our infrastructure. We can take most important things from here, like the local storage usage from the local free of the storage usage, our virtual machine, our physical machines, and add other agents that is installed in our infrastructure to backup our data. Our local agent information about network address, latest backup, operating system version, how much is CPUs and RAM using, and what's the agent version. This is pretty much simple steps to install our agent in our infrastructure. We just click the Protect tab. After that, we can choose between agent-based system and agentless system. If you want to use the agentless system, we just need to synchronize our data appliance with our hypervisor. It can be VMware, it can be Hyper-V, SXI, etc. It doesn't matter. Or we can choose to agent-based system. All we need to do is just download the agent, install on our machine, and after that, when we click agent-based system, just add the hostname or IP address. Everything after that will get automatically connect to our appliance, and we have multiple options to choose to configure it. We can choose these options here. After that, close this window. We can like choose configure agent setting for one of my virtual machines, so it will be easier to understand. First of all, we have Pulse backups and Pulse cloud backups. This is important that the Pulse backups is Pulse every backup that we are doing from this machine. The Pulse cloud backups only Pulse the backups that are getting to the cloud. So every local backup that we get configured on this virtual machine will still get on. After that, we have our retention policy for the local backup. As you can see, we can choose how often I want to backup my device. First of all, I want to backup my device every 5 minutes to hour, starting at X time and ending at Y time. And of course, days of the week, like Monday through Friday or every year. After that, I can apply that. And I can choose my set retention for local backups. For local backups, we can choose from 1 week to forever. It depends how we want to use our appliance. I prefer to use like 1 week for normal machines, normal devices. If we have some more important devices, we can choose the more retention local backups, like 2 weeks. But we need to know like the machine that we are buying have enough space or like X backups, but not like forever. Or if we are sure that it will longer last forever, it's fine. After that, we can choose our cloud backup and retention policy. This is the normal graph when we want to like get our backups to the cloud from our appliance. And of course, we see our retention for cloud backups. Right now, it's for the 1 year. As Robert mentioned before, it can be 1 year or, to be honest, forever, as long as we have deal with the data. Of course, we have options to the backup engine options. We have application aware VAS with DBD fallback, data backup driver only, or application aware VAS only. The best and recommended is, of course, application aware VAS with DBD fallback, and the less is application aware VAS only. After that, we can see our volume level backup control. As you can see, we have on the PUFC, use space 25 gigabytes, capacity 63 gigabytes. So that's pretty much it. And the options that Robert mentioned before, integrity, verification, and ransomware detection, of course, we can turn it on in these options. So after we choose our agent, install it, and we know that our agents are working and we backup our system, we can choose how we want to restore our data. First of all, we see some local and rescue options on the left. Local is all our agents, like LandGuard, Desktop, BDClean, is all my virtual machines. But Rescue is the virtual machine that I started on the appliance. I will talk to you about it later. So if I choose my desktop that I want to restore, I have a couple of options. First, file restore, volume restore, local virtualization, virtualization in the cloud, virtualization via hypervisor, SXI upload, bare metal restore, and export image. The most important right now, it's file restore, local virtualization, bare metal restore, or export image. If you want to choose the file restore, just click it. We can choose to start restore the backup that we want to use. So we can just choose the newest one. And after I click start restore, I have options to mount my recovery point to my agent, my device where agent is installed. If I click mount, I just wait a little bit and I have access from my device to this backup. If I go to my files, go to my backup folder, as you can see, I can choose and I can go and choose any folder, any file that I want to copy on my normal device. I can go to any other backups that are made from any other agents right now because I don't want to. I want to keep it private. But if I don't want to get access from this device to the backup, I can, of course, just close it and use the Access Web Share. If I choose to Access Web Share, I can go to any other folders, any other file that is backed up and just download it. It doesn't matter. I can download whole folder. I can download only one file. I just click on it and the download will start to my device. So if I want to download this data on the device that doesn't make that wasn't agent installed, that was making a backup, I can just choose to the Access Web file. If I want to do it on the same device, I can just go and mount the recovery drive. So this is the first option, so the file restore. The local virtualization and virtualization in the cloud is, to be honest, the most important for our most important machines. So if we have some production servers, some productions, machines, some directors, devices, and we don't want to lose so much time to recover that, we can just choose local virtualization. If I go to the local virtualization and click start restore, I just go and, to be honest, start the virtual machine on my Datto appliance. And of course, it's the same in the cloud virtualization. I will just start my virtual machine in the cloud. I can use my CPU cores that I wanted to use, my system RAM, my controller, and network options. Network options is the most important if you want to check if device wasn't corrupted, like ransomware and other malware viruses, etc. We have options to firewall on private subnet with no internet access. And after that, if we turn on the machine that has ransomware in, we want to check which backups doesn't have it, but is it dangerous because some can have it. We can just choose this option for the network. And we know that we won't corrupt whole infrastructure in our company. And for the last, video control options, VGA or Cyrus. The checkbox I have on my right, create rescue agent, stay backup of your running virtual machines. Is what I showed you before. So if I go to restore and I have one agent that's called rescue 10080152. This is like my virtual machine that was started on the appliance and is backed up as well. So I still back up my original device if it starts working, and I still back up my work on the virtual machine that's on the appliance, or if you choose it, as you can see, in the cloud. So yeah, if I can go to the manage rescue agents and I can just start my virtual machine, I just wait a little bit for it to start. And to be honest, I can just join it and start working on my virtual machine. So if I choose to open it in a browser, we see the authentication method and just wait for the system to start because it's working like normal operating systems. After my machine starts, I can just turn my credentials on so I can log in. I don't give much RAM here and calls, so it can be a little laggy. You can, of course, make it more less laggy by adding more RAM and calls, of course. And if I log in to my device on the virtual machine, you will see that I have access to every folder, every file that has this user. The most important thing, this virtual machine that I'm showing you right now, that is virtualized on the appliance, I'm logged in right now. So I am logged in right now on the virtual machine that is backed up. So I'm working on this virtual machine. I used to back up it on my agent that's called desktop. And every sweet change I do here, it will be backed up to my rescue 1080-150. So we can like work similar on one and the other agent. Everything will be backed up, and for everything we will have access. And the last part of the restore, we have bare metal restore if we want to use it. Of course, we choose it, make it for some physical servers, physical devices. Just plug in the controller, and after that, the bare metal restore will start. Or we can export image to do it, to put it on the hypervisor or some similar virtualization. We, of course, export image as VHD, VHDX, VMDK, or VMDK linked. After that, we know how to protect our devices. We know how to restore data from our vault, our cloud, our appliance. And we can only go to configure and see what can we make for our appliance. As you can see, I can see the most important thing. So my network status from our interfaces, ATH0 and ATH1, I only connected to ATH0. My connectivity status of 5th of the May 2021. As you can see, everything is kind of fine without heartbeat and VLOG. It's because my appliance was turned off like 1 hour ago. In the settings, I can choose what IP I want to give it, if it's static or DHCP. If I want to use a NetMask and gateway, of course, I can use it as well on my ATH1 interface. Here is a DHCP. If I want to bond my interface, if I want to switch my DNS settings, right now it's like normal Google settings from the DNS server. And I can change my host name, or I can change my Windows networking. If I have like Active Directory or any similar effects, I can just add it to my networking Windows workgroup. And of course, IPMI settings. The appliance has the IPMI port, so I can choose to join and remotely power on off the device or search for the perform device hardware checking. If I want to, of course, I can choose to add like the administration that I will log in. But yeah, I have full access from the APMI. This is the quick presentation of the data solution from the Cyrus, from the backup. Thank you for your time, and I'm giving back my voice to the robot.
Okay, thank you all. Thank you, Błażej, for your part of demo presentation, and thank you all for participating in our today's webinar. You can now see a direct contact for us at datto@bakotech.com. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to get in touch. We wish all you a good day and goodbye. Thank you.